Hi everyone, and welcome back and welcome to my new playlist. And in this playlist we are going to do a little bit different, like we are going to talk about Nest.js Advanced. I already have a lot of playlists in which I covered the very basics, beginner or intermediate stuff in Nest.js. How to write your Node.js API backend using Node.js, using Node.js Nest.js with the type ORM, either Postgres, MySQL, using Docker and all these things, okay? So basics we already know. What now we are going to talk about is a lot of interesting stuff, what you can do with Nest.js. So I will not be like talking about the boilerplate code and all. We already have this. We have already talked about these things like the basic boilerplate, how to do the database connections, how to write the controllers, services, the DTOs and all these things. What we will do in this playlist specifically, okay, how to write middleware, how to write a custom interceptor, right? How to do the data validation of a nested payload, right? How to deal with this JSON Web Token, or how to do the authentication with the help of Passport, and how to serialize your response through the interceptors, and creating the relationship with the Postgres, MySQL, using type ORM. Writing unit test is also important thing in the Nest.js, and writing the end-to-end test, either using Mocha NYC or using Jest, okay? Then how this Nest.js API backend can talk to a multiple services. Now we are not writing Express, so we can just directly go ahead and use the Redis and different Node.js SDK libraries. We have to dependent on the Nest.js set of libraries, like, okay, how do we do the deployment of this Nest.js application on Heroku, AWS, Azure, and how we run the migration with the help of TypeORM. How do we do the integration with, let's say, Azure Blob or AWS S3 or some other vendor? How to do the integration of Nest.js with Elasticsearch, Redis, RabbitMQ, Kafka, because we need to be good at selecting the particular module which Nest.js is providing. Nest.js Redis, Nest.js RabbitMQ, all these modules will help us to communicate to these third-party services. We'll also talk about Nest.js CQRS, Nest.js CRUD, Nest.js microservice module, Nest.js cron scheduler, or how to do the file upload in Nest.js using Muttler, right? So these are some miscellaneous aspects, and we sometimes not able to get things correctly. We just create controllers, we create services, we have everything, we understand the folder structure, but when it comes to some miscellaneous, okay, let's implement a logger in Nest.js, let's implement API interceptor in Nest.js, how to do the error handling, error logging in Nest.js, right? How to write a custom middleware. So all these things will be like a miscellaneous topic, and we must understand like how to do the communication with the gRPC, with the another external HTTP service, or how to write a CQRS pattern in the Nest.js, how to write a multiple microservices in Nest.js, how to deal with a different set of microservice communication, how that is happening, right? How we are doing the error handling. So if we talk about these 12 factor principles in any microservice, because what we are doing is we are writing these Nest.js as a microservice or a service, right? So are we following these 12 factor principles where we need to make sure the high availability, reliability, and the scalability, all these different aspects of a particular service. So about the security, what all security modules you should use, how you can do the health check of your Nest.js service with the Terminus module, which Nest.js is providing itself. So there are a lot of areas which I have not covered in my past series, like totally these are missed, because when you talk about the beginner or intermediate, those are not covered. Now we are talking about building a robust and secure microservice using Nest.js. Nest.js is becoming popular. I will not say that you can't write services in Express, but it is giving you the unified structure of doing everything with the help of TypeScript. Okay, so if you love writing TypeScript and love writing the APIs, then Nest.js is the the option for you, and this playlist is going to help you in doing some custom things. Okay, I want to do the payload validation. I don't know. I want to do populate each and everything in my Swagger using these different annotations which class validator is providing, which this Swagger module is providing. So you might already know Nest.js, but there are a few things which I have gone through since last couple of months, and I think like these are must to cover. So I will be covering all these things, so stay tuned. Without talking much, let's talk about services and controllers, and then we'll talk about DTO validations of nested objects, and then we'll talk about the config module which Nest.js is providing. I mean, you can manage the configs, runtime environment configurations, either using .env, either using config module, or write your own config service. Many ways, so we'll talk about all these things. So stay tuned. Thanks everyone. Let's connect in the next video.